boys and girls, I have a question for you. Have you ever heard the saying, a picture is worth a thousand words?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yep.
Okay. Matt, what does that mean to you?
It means sometimes when you look at a picture, you can tell a lot of things from it.
Right. Max, do you have anything to add to that?
That's pretty much it.
Okay. Maddie, anything?
Just worth a thousand words, not more than words can say.
So you can look at a picture and no one has to say anything, but you can interpret a lot of things through that picture. Maddie's helping me today, but you can see I have some pictures looping through on the computer here. These are portraits, so they're pictures of people's faces. So let's stop on this one. What can you tell me about this girl, just off the top of your head, Max? What would you say?
She seems to be in a good mood.
Right. Madeline, anything?
She looks friendly.
She looks friendly. How about you, Matt?
She looks happy.
Happy, great. In a good mood, happy, friendly. Let's look at the next portrait. Okay, what about this little boy? Anybody have any ideas? Can you raise your hand if you have a thought? Madeline?
He looks dirty and like he's been working.
Dirty, like he's been working. Anybody else have anything? Any impression of this boy from the picture? Max?
He looks unhappy.
He looks unhappy. Right, what makes you think that? To me, it's his furrowed eyebrows. He looks, I would almost say he looks intense. Anybody else have anything to say about this young man?
Yeah, intense or angry.
Angry? Okay, let's check out the next picture, please, Madeline. Okay, how about this man? What is something obvious you can tell me about this person just from the picture? Madeline?
It's an Indian.
It's an Indian. Yes, we can tell that with no words whatsoever. Anybody else have anything they'd like to say about this picture?
He looks strong.
He looks strong. Anyone else?
He seems to be dressed in fancy clothes.
Fancy clothes, or if we think back to our Tanaika story, grandfather character, traditional Indian wear, so maybe he takes his heritage very seriously. How about our final picture? Okay, what would you say about this man? Hey, I just gave away something. He's a man. We know that obvious things from the picture. He's not a little boy. He's not a little girl. Madeline?
He looks happy.
He looks happy. He does look a little bit happy.
Mm-hmm.
Anybody else want to say anything about this man?
It looks like he's enjoying himself.
Enjoying himself. Looks like he's lived a long life, wouldn't you say?
Mm-hmm.
So there are lots of things we can tell, thank you, Madeline, just from looking at a portrait. These are photographic portraits of people. I have right there, Matt, if you don't mind start taking that book. This is a book of painted portraits of people that I'm going to allow you to pass around the room as we talk about this lesson. I've earmarked four different pictures for you, so just quietly take a look at those and pass those around. Just more examples of portraits. Okay, I'm going to, before we get into our assignment, let's talk about what we know. We've spent 2 days talking about Tanaika, a story by Mary Whitebird. Just a quick recap. This is a story about a family of Kaw Indians. The grandfather is very traditional, and he's wanting his grandchild Mary, to go through a rite of passage when she turns 11. That's called Tanaika, where the children are to go off into the woods by themselves and just survive. And back when grandfather was a child, they were gone for days with nothing. They went out naked, and if they came back, they were worthy to be a warrior or worthy to be a woman. If they didn't, they either came back sick or they passed. That meant they weren't worthy. Grandfather still thinks it's important for Mary in 1947 to go through this ritual. She does not see the importance of it, neither does Roger. So the story tells us how Mary deals with the ordeal and what she thinks about it. And so I think you all remember that. We did some Venn diagrams talking about comparing and contrasting Mary and Roger, her cousin, who was also turning 11, comparing and contrasting Mary and grandfather. And then we also filled out a worksheet with some basic comprehension questions. But today I'm going to ask you to look a little deeper into our main character, Mary. We are going to be doing an open mind portrait. Okay? You're going to be expressing your thoughts of Mary, the main character. You will illustrate a depiction of Mary on the cover of your open mind portrait, and on the following pages, you will create images which support how Mary is feeling at certain points in the story. If you look at the board here, I have listed 1, 2, 3, 4 the specific points in the story that I would like for you to address. I'll talk briefly with you about them, but if you've forgotten what happened at that point, I wrote down the page numbers, so feel free once we get going to go to your cubby and get your textbook if you need that. But the first point in the story is, what were Mary's thoughts about Tanaika in the beginning, leading up to her 11th birthday? What did she think about it? The second point is, what is Mary's point of view as she rests in the woods? Okay? The third, Ernie says Tanaika is a silly tradition. How does that make Mary feel? How does she react? And did that reaction surprise her? And finally, the fourth event in the story that I would like for you to look at is, after Mary finished Tanaika and was back with her family, what were her thoughts? How did she feel? The open-minded portrait is, I'm asking you to think more deeply about a character and reflect on story events from the character's viewpoint. Any questions so far? We will talk a little more about what I expect from you, but you all understand the general idea of the open mind portrait? Okay, great. So, we will recall how Mary felt about Tanaika, like I said, in that first example before she even has to go off on the event. So the first page, let's talk about the pages and the grading. This first page, each page, and there are 5 pages, the portrait page and the 4 events. Each page is worth 5 points. So we have 5 pages worth 5 points each. So who can tell me how many points this lesson is worth, this assignment? Anybody? Matt.
20 points.
Well, it's 5 pages, Matt, with 5. Yes, there's only 4 events here, but we have the portrait page. So 5 times 5.
25.
Excellent, Matthew. You know your math facts. It's a little confusing because I only have the 4 points here, but don't forget the first page is the portrait page. So this will be worth 25 points. On the first page, what I would like to see from you is the title and the author and the character we are discussing. One thing I need to mention to you is you will also be including your vocabulary words. We talked over these vocabulary words before we read the story. It's been 2 days ago. And then, of course, you read about these words in the story in context. So I would like for you to use 1 vocabulary word per page. You're going to decide which page best suits or best fits those vocabulary words. For instance, this is kind of a gimme. On the first page, the portrait page, I wrote ritual, okay? Because to me, the whole story is talking about Tanaika, which is a ritual. So page number 1, you get 1 point, title, author, character. 1 point, vocabulary word. 3 points for your portrait. I want to see that you put some time into it. I'm not grading your skills. We are not all gifted artists. I want to see color. I want to see effort. And I want them all to look different. We all have a different image in our head of what Mary looks like. Mine, she looks a little older than 11, I would say. Maybe that's because I'm older, so. Now, pages 2 through 5, they will be graded the same. On each page, I need at least 3 pictures or phrases that help depict what you think Mary is thinking or feeling, or something that represents her perspective during these certain events in the story. Okay, so your second page, event number 1, at least 3 pictures. Third page, event number 2, at least 3 pictures or phrases, and so on and so on. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. You will also be graded 1 point. Make sure you put your vocabulary word on there, because that is worth 1 point. Your 5th point on all these pages, effort. I want to see color. Write the word down with a short definition. Make sure you're spelling things correctly. As an example, Mary's first impressions of Tanaika. I wrote 11 because that's the magic number. Grandfather wants him to eat grasshoppers. So I put a grasshopper down, and you know, Mary thinks that's yucky. So in her brain, she's thinking, oh, I have to eat grasshoppers. She's come up with some clever ways she's gonna get through this Tanaika. So I kind of put a light bulb, like, ooh, what's Mary thinking? And then I chose a vocabulary word. Any questions on that? Okay, great. Let me see. So you will sketch your thoughts about Mary's feelings using pictures, phrases if you'd like. You need to support your thoughts about her feelings or point of view through those phrases or pictures. Here are your Open Mind Portrait booklets.
Thank you.
Anybody have any questions yet? No. Okay, great. Let me see what else I want to cover with you. Pass out your booklets. I've got pencils and markers on the table for you. You may quietly talk with people in your little seating pods. You can share colors. If you get stuck on something, you can ask a question. And if you recall, we talked about the Ute Indian tribe I visited with my kids, and I showed you all this piece of pottery we got from Cortez. It's a traditional art of the Ute Indians, so I just thought I'd bring that back for a little inspiration for you all. Alrighty, so you have a couple minutes now to go ahead and get started, and I will be right back, okay? Keep going. One thing I failed to mention is no need to rush, because you will be working on this tomorrow as well. So we'll take today and tomorrow to work on our open mind portraits, okay? So just to recap what we've done today, we took a look at some portraits and talked about how a picture represents 1,000 words, and what we can assume or guess about a person just from their picture, their portrait. We recapped the story of Tanaika and the assignments we had the day before yesterday and yesterday, and we are just delving a little deeper into our main character and also refreshing with our vocabulary. So we are working on these open mind portraits today and tomorrow. One question I have for you is, do you think it's your place to judge how Mary reacted or what her thoughts and perspectives were during these events in the story? Am I asking you to judge? Am I asking you to say, that was stupid? Does anybody think that's what I'm getting at? Mm-hmm. So it's not really our place to judge. I want your thoughts, but I don't really want your opinions on what Mary did. So it's just you are needing to put yourself in Mary's shoes and think about how Mary was feeling, okay? So remember to select a vocabulary word that helps depict each event in the story, and don't forget a vocabulary word on your first page. And please make sure your illustrations represent Mary. Maddie, are you gonna be okay? Can you make it through class? Okay. Max, do you think you could spend a little more time on that portrait, buddy? I think if you turn that into me, you might not get these 3 points for your portrait. Okay, so thank you. Keep working, and I'll let you know when we need to clean up our area. And scene.